The Do Book Company presents Do Story by Bobette Buster, read by the author. Were it not for the storyteller, civilization would destroy itself. Albert Camus. To my father Robert, the greatest storyteller I have ever known, and to my mother Shirley, the greatest listener and laugher, along with my brothers three. Chief among my memories is all of us gathered round the round table, hoping the long evenings of storytelling would never end. And for me, they never did. Introduction. Carry the Fire, Cormac McCarthy. Stories are the fire we carry to each other. In Cormac McCarthy's novel, No Country for Old Men, Sheriff Bell recalls that his cowboy father would carry the embers from the fire of one camp to the next in an animal horn. It was a tradition passed to the cowboys by the Native American Indians. In the novel, this important act had another meaning: to have hope and continue the quest, but also to maintain humanity. The fire carrier would hold a special position in the tribe and for their society. Stories possess a spark, a power, to comfort, connect, destroy, transform, and even to heal. Everyone has a story to tell, and everyone can appreciate a great story well told. But we are not all gifted storytellers. However, in all my years of teaching the art of storytelling around the world, I have never known anyone to fail at learning how to tell their story beautifully once they learned what you will discover in this book. Storytelling, as you will see, is elemental within each of us. The very act of telling your story possesses power. It is through the act of telling and hearing stories that we become inspired. We can envision a better life for ourselves. The end result is, in fact, that we become courageous. And then a curious thing happens. Our actions, our individual act of courage, are what lead to healing in the land, that is, the transformation of our world. But equally powerful is the inverse. The power of storytelling can be lethal. The fact is, history has shown us that stories not told can become like an evil genie left in a bottle. When they are finally uncorked, their power to destroy is unleashed. Consider the recent case in the United States on November the 5th, 2011, when it was revealed that one of the U.S.'s most revered college football coaches, Joe Paterno of Pennsylvania State College, known as Penn State, had withheld vital information for over 14 years, that his assistant coach, Jerry Sandusky, had been accused of 40 cases of child sex abuse. Joe, known as Joe Pa, was possibly the most beloved football coach in U.S. history. But he simply didn't possess the courage to tell the truth. He could not face the reality of the story he was in. And when it finally came out, Joe Paterno was summarily fired, causing students to riot in support of him. He died 6 weeks later from lung cancer. Jerry Sandusky was tried and found guilty. Equally, stories can destroy with their gossip, innuendo, and character defamation. The demise of Rupert Murdoch's News of the World was at long last achieved when both the public and the United Kingdom's government could no longer tolerate the newspaper management's blatant disregard for a grieving family's privacy. Yet the News of the World's long reign of power was largely due to the public's mob-like appetite for the story, no matter how dubiously it had been obtained. This book will not be about these sensationalist stories or tellers. Rather, this book is about the power of stories to heal, to restore, to share a vision, and most of all, to inspire others. This will be the stuff of the stories you will read in the ensuing chapters, and all of them are personal and true. You'll hear about charity entrepreneurs driven by the fact that they could no longer afford the luxury of their ignorance, about citizen diplomats, community activists, and a cast-off politician who saved the world. you will discover the power of alchemy as we enter worlds we would otherwise never know in Copenhagen, Uganda, a suburb of Paris, and a small town in Kentucky. As I share these stories with you, I will encourage you to notice certain elements or shared characteristics that turn them from good to great. And it is these elements that I hope you will start to display in your own storytelling. All we have had from our caveman campfire days until relatively recently, in historical terms, was the oral tradition. The wisdom of the ages has been handed down by the shamans, medicine men, or griots from tribal cultures the world over via folklore, fairy tales, myths, and legends. This is how each generation was psychologically prepared for their future, to be ready to know that they would not only be able to survive, but thrive amid life's inevitable adversities. It has been said that the Industrial Age ended after World War II. Then it was superseded by the Age of Information via the computer, the 1960s boom in Madison Avenue advertising, see the hit television series Mad Men, and television itself. And then with the internet boom of the 1990s, there followed in 2003 the viral explosion of social media. With it, a new deceiving conceit arose, that anything worth knowing is available at our fingertips. This immediacy has, curiously, made people less curious about discovering the world, at least in any depth. Now, with 24/7 news cycles, hours spent tweeting or updating Facebook pages with daily minutiae, and endless reality television shows, the full power of storytelling, its contextual beauty and majestic ability to move us, is on the wane. What this means is that today's children may know the facts, but not the context in which things happen. And as they are no longer being shaped by a storytelling world, they seem to lack the will to dig deeper, preferring to surf in the immediate. I was struck by this recently when a graduate from one of America's most elite schools asked me, "Was John Lennon in that group, Wings?" Or when a student at France's top film program, La Famille, asked me offhandedly, "What was it that Jean-Luc Godard did that was so great?" Or when I overheard a Detroit mother of three share a major revelation to her, without irony. She said, "I just found out that George Washington was the father of our country. I always wondered who that was on the quarter." This, despite the fact that every year on the third Monday of February, the U.S. has a national holiday to celebrate President's Day in honor of George Washington and Abraham Lincoln's birthdays. When I was in school, and I dare say for the previous 200 years, on February the 22nd of each year, every school child learned the story of George Washington, that when he was a boy, he freely confessed to his father, "I cannot tell a lie, I chopped down that cherry tree." This story was like the air we breathed. A recent groundbreaking study for children, Do You Know?, created by psychologist Dr. Marshall Duke of Emory University and his colleague Dr. Robin Fivush, has discovered the single best predictor of children's emotional health and happiness: story. Apparently, the more a child knows his family story, in other words, the better informed the child is about his or her wider family and the obstacles they had to overcome in order to survive and thrive, the stronger a child's sense of control will be over his or her life, and the higher his or her self-esteem will become. The issue is getting parents to sit down with their children and tell them their stories. But perhaps they never sat down with their own parents long enough to learn their parents' stories. However, all is not lost. It would appear that we are now entering a new age, the age of story. Back to the campfire, or rather, it's the era of content creation. That is, whoever owns the best story will win. So it is vital that we each learn to tell our story well so that our stories become the best they can be. But first, We must respect the fact that no story...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.